Miami took a toll on me.
What's up, everybody? I got Taylor Holder behind the camera here because he's a cameraman, not a YouTuber.
Hey.
Miami, dude! I'm just gonna try to explain how Miami went for me. Yeah, that basically sums up my whole trip. Literally just that. Taylor, what did we do?
What have we done or what have you done?
What have I done?
Blacked out every night.
True. Okay, it's literally stuff straight out of a movie, guys. I promise you. I'm like, I haven't drank in a while. I'm on vacation in Miami right now. I'm watching Jake's fight. You know, we're supposed to go to the Super Bowl. Blah, 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 right? I'm like, you know, I'm going to have a few drinks. Nothing wrong with that, right? Ended up happening every day. I swear, I woke up like, okay, I'm not doing this again. And then I get a text. Exclusive party. And I'm just like...
Stop.
I have to keep going, dude. It's my last day in Miami. You know what I have to do? I have to pee off the balcony.
No, Bryce, get in here. We're not doing this again.
I'm peeing off the balcony.
We're not doing this.
I need to pee off.
We're not doing this again. Get the f*** inside.
All right, screw all this playlist. I need to talk about what happened here. So, I have a little message to Jake Paul's friend. Nothing against Jake Paul, but something happened. I don't know if you guys see this. Right here, it's a little black eye.
Yeah, you got his ass beat.
I got my ass beat. So no, I'm gonna explain that. You guys probably don't know exactly what happened, so I'm just gonna give you a little rundown on what actually happened and what I plan to do on in the future with that. All right, let's go sit down over here. You can be here, you can be here. Yeah, set it on the paper towels.
Yeah.
Am I good?
Mm-hmm.
Can you come next to me?
Oh. Yeah. I didn't know you wanted me to be in this.
All right, let's get freaking serious, dude.
Basically, let me give you guys a rundown of what happened. If you guys are familiar with what happened the other night with Bryce getting in a fight.
Yeah, because this is Taylor's channel.
Yeah, Addison broke Bryce's heart, and so he decided to go back to his old ways and started beating the shit out of people, and that's it.
Bro. Yeah, yeah. Anyways, I lost my voice because I consumed enough alcohol the past 5 days to kill a small Indian tribe. All right, Jake Paul's friend. Okay, so a few nights ago, I don't know if you guys are hip, a fight broke out at the Jake Paul Gibber fight. Did you know that? Like a randomers. Uh-huh. The random people fought. Not like boxers. And it was me! It was me and Jake Paul's friend! As you know, Taylor and I make TikToks, and we are TikTokers to most YouTubers' eyes. For some reason, most YouTubers clown on us. I mean, I can see why.
I see why.
This guy grinds on views.
I was just about to say that.
Yeah, I got you. Cool. I beat you there. This kid was not doing it in like a joking, friendly way. He was calling us TikTokers, TikToker. Like, he was making fun of me for being a TikToker. I said, ha ha, like, this TikToker can still knock you the f*** out. Then he got pissed at that for some reason. I don't know why. I can see why, but he was clowning me. I let it happen. I let it slide for like 30 minutes. Then we went off on each other, like completely, like just yelling at each other back and forth. He said he had shooters outside waiting for me if I kept talking. I did. I'm still here. Taylor broke that up pretty fast. Like, it was just kind of like he said he had shooters outside. He said he could beat my ass.
I told Bryce, whether you can beat the out of him or not, whenever people start talking about shooting people and all that stuff, it's just really not even worth it. There's a fine line of being smart and like just being the Hulk.
But when he said he could beat my ass, my initial reaction was kind of messed up. I laughed at him. Like, because here's a picture of this kid. Yeah. He said that. So yeah, I laughed very, very hard. And then the shit off ended because Taylor split it up. After the fight, after Jake won, it was like, what, a 30-minute span where we weren't talking shit anymore? I look back, and then these kids are like staring at me, like taunting me, like, what's the one kid's name with the shoes? His something kicks. Something kicks,
Benjamin?
And yeah, Benjamin kicks, and Jake Paul's friend were staring at me. She's giving me a look, and I went, ooh, like, both middle fingers up, I did the woo, like face. He started talking shit, saying he'd f*** me up again. We were going back and forth for like not even 30 seconds, and then he hucked a loogie on my freaking mouth, dude. A freaking fat one. I felt the boogers and shit in his throat, all in my face was shits. So my dumbass, being me, I was like, okay. That's where you cross the line of being just like an asshole and disrespectful as f***. So I picked him up, I jumped across the table. I picked him up because he was standing on a table, ran him about like 3 or 4 steps, and then I threw him on the ground. And then I realized in my head, oh shit, I just f***ed up, which I did. I shouldn't have laid my hands on him. Spitting is considered assault, so he did assault me first. But it was wrong of me to slam this kid, especially because literally could beat this kid to a pulp. So when I did that, I realized immediately, like even though I was a little tipsy, I immediately was like, oh God, we got flown out by like Jake and like the apps and everything. Like I'm being represented, like we're representing like Jake's team, blah, blah, blah. Like I just fucked up. Like I just got into a fight, at a fight. I guess it doesn't sound that bad when you say it out loud, but it is. So it clicked in my head, I messed up. So I went like this, security guard split it up. I went like this, both my hands up. He didn't touch me, his boys tried to hit me. They were hitting me in the back of the head. But then I went like this, and he punched me in the face like a little scumbag. First off, spit on my face. He punched me while my hands were up. He stole my wallet, my chain, and he tried to spend money on my card. So with all those things added up, I think that's a good reason to literally slap the shit out of him. But I didn't. I didn't do that. I thought in my head the consequences for the first time ever. Well, Bryce is maturing.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm maturing a little bit.
Yeah, you're maturing. You slam a guy on the table and then you're like, yeah.
And a bunch of stuff.
I will admit, I haven't seen you get a fight in a minute, so
yeah,
it's
right.
Good job, man.
Yes, we're getting paid for it. Yeah. So we were supposed to squash beef a few days ago. But he brought everything to social media. He said, no marks on my face. Like, he actually texted me asking to like squash it. And we went downstairs to the gym to talk about it. And I thought it was gonna be like a pretty chill thing. I would've been like, all right, dude, you stole my wallet, my chain. Like, you disrespected me, blah, blah, blah. Don't care. I'm gonna put it behind me. I was gonna actually respectfully dab this kid up, which is stupid. But I was. And then this man had the audacity, the ball sack, the nutshells in his freaking penal area to ask me for $2,000 for his stupid jacket that a security guard ripped. I'll play the clip right now, actually. So that wasn't me that ripped it, it was a security guard. He asked me for $2,000. So I said, what the shits? Hell no, I'm not gonna pay you $2,000. My wallet alone was like $700, my chain was $3,000. Like everything that you stole is worth more than your jacket, bro. But I will give him this. This is the message that I have to you, Jake Paul's friend. I do have a proposal for you. There's a boxing ring. If you beat me in a fight, I'll give you $2,000 cash. If you don't, you can go fuck yourself. I'm not aggressive anymore. I don't like to do this stuff, but I'm telling you, bro, I'm not like these kids on the internet. Keep my name out of your mouth. That's all I wanted to say. I love you guys. Jake Paul's friend, fuck you. All right, peace, guys. Sorry for me being serious, but I had to get that out of my system. I had to talk to you guys. All right, I'm done. Peace.